Hello everyone. This video is about some of the misleading indicators I think may be used by many countries to monitor their COVID-19 situation and update their risk evaluation. I need to start with a few statements first. COVID-19 has no one-size-fits-all kind of thing. Every country should have its own way of monitoring and handling. What works, for example, for China may not work for country X or country Y. This video is mainly directed towards low and middle income developing countries, which have limited resources to do consistent mass testing for COVID-19, and those countries with weaker healthcare systems. Every day, we wake up and check COVID-19 updates, and different governments usually announce many numbers, but six main numbers are usually announced every day. New cases, total cases, new recoveries and total recoveries, and new fatalities and total fatalities. Well, these numbers are okay, but only two of them may be reliable in the case of COVID-19. Sadly, these are the new fatalities and the total fatalities. There is a concern about new cases and new recoveries. Simply, they can never be true or real per se. These numbers may work for other epidemics or diseases, but may not be reliable in the scenario of COVID-19. Even the titles we give to those numbers are not accurate. Those are not just new cases. We'd rather call them the number of patients who tested positive out of the total that we tested in 24 hours plus backlog from past days or weeks, which is quite a long name. There may be many more infected people who were not tested as well. Some countries prefer to use an indicator called the doubling time, which is basically the time needed for cases to double in number. For example, how many days needed to go from 20 cases to 40 cases? The longer the time, the better. This may work for other types of diseases, for example, like SARS, which do not have a lot of asymptomatic cases and may be reliable, but I do not believe they may work well for COVID-19. COVID-19 spreads very fast and has a very wide range of effects from being totally asymptomatic to manifesting severe illness. No country can confirm or be 100% sure about its real number of cases or recoveries, especially countries with limited resources and inconsistent testing. To clarify the scale of this concern, I want you to have a look at the results of this interesting study conducted in the state of New York in USA over the past few weeks. The governor of New York State coordinated the testing of some 15,000 people for COVID-19 antibodies. Antibodies are proteins found in the blood of those who were infected and recovered. The surprise results came out that there may be around 12.3% of New York State's population positive for the COVID-19 antibodies. This is roughly around 2.5 million people that may have been infected with the virus and recovered. The link for this study is in the video description. Do you still believe that we should consider the number of new cases or its doubling time as a reliable indicator? For COVID-19, the number of new cases could drastically change based on the number of tests that you do every day. If you conduct 1,000 tests and you get 300 cases positive, what will happen if you conduct 2,000 tests? Not to mention the thousands who got the disease and recovered without even being tested. Okay, doctor, so what indicator should we look at? Well, the number of fatalities due to COVID-19 may be a much more reliable indicator to look at. And if not, then there is another number that I rarely see reported publicly, that is the number of hospitalized cases due to COVID-19. If a country really insists on doing their risk assessment for COVID-19 based on the doubling time, it should not be the doubling time of cases, which as we discussed, may be quite unreliable. It is recommended to calculate the doubling time of fatalities, or worst case, the doubling time of hospitalized cases. These indicators may be more reliable. One more thing is when you give me numbers that are not confirmed and not consistent, like the number of new cases, for me as a public health specialist, I have other indicators that I will calculate and may be all confused because I will use the number of cases that you give me to calculate those indicators. For example, when we calculate an indicator called the case fatality rate, we simply divide the number of fatalities due to the disease by the number of cases over a period of time. the case fatality rate is very important because it tells us how deadly the disease may be or how many people die out of those infected. So if we have 300 fatalities and lower number of cases, this means that the disease kills more people and has a high risk. If the same number of fatalities, 300, comes from a very high number of cases, then it may not be that bad. To recap, number of cases or new cases and the doubling time of cases may not be reliable for decision making in the case of COVID-19. It may be better to focus on the number of fatalities or the number of hospitalized cases. Further research may be needed on this matter. Every country should do its own risk assessment and research based on reliable statistics. Do not just follow other countries. And always remember, risk level may be a number, but risk acceptability is a leadership decision. Thank you.